This is our new production and testing environment for live streaming and setup installation software. We're gonna talk about it all right here on this setup. Now, if you're brand new here, my name is Monty Weaver and I help you navigate this world of digital tech and social media. And we're gonna be talking about live streaming today, specifically for my small churches and my smaller ministries, because there is no excuse not to be live streaming, no matter what your budget is, no matter how many or how few volunteers that you have. I'm gonna walk you through a super easy setup that would only take one person to operate, and wanna walk you through all the connections, the software, and the hardware that you're gonna need in order to get it done. By now, if you have been live streaming, I'm sure that you've been paying attention to the analytics and statistics of your viewership, especially on YouTube, because they allow you to see where your viewers are watching from. And you've probably noticed that you're getting viewers from just outside of your normal congregation. You're probably getting videos from other parts of the world, which is amazing. That means they love tuning in, they love your message, and we want to continue to have them as part of our online and our virtual audience. So we want to step up our production. We want to make it look quality. We want to set the standard. But I want you to watch this quick video because this is going to be the software that we're going to use, and you're definitely want to take a look at it and incorporate this into your production. This video is sponsored by Restream. Are you looking for an easy way to start live streaming? Restream is a simple web-based software that requires no installation. Just select your microphone, camera, social media accounts, or custom destination and start live streaming to over 30 platforms simultaneously. Restream allows you to create custom branded broadcasts with overlays and more. Need to manage all your comments in one place? Restream allows you to bring all your comments together in one easy-to-view location, easy to manage, and engage with your audience in real time. The Restream Studio mode allows you to bring in guests and host multiple attendees for your next live stream broadcast. Click the link in the description of this video to receive $10 towards your brand new Restream account. So as you can see, Restream is an amazing software, so make sure that you create your account and get that set up. But before we get into the Restream software, we first need to set up all the hardware. So I've cleaned off this area so that we can use this to do our complete setup, and I'm gonna walk you through everything that I'm gonna use. Now, obviously, some of your equipment may be a little bit different, but just keep in mind, at the end of the day, it's pretty much the same thing. It's just a matter of quality, a matter of different specs specifically, but the concepts and the workflow are gonna be the exact same. So let's get started walking through this setup. Now, first off, we're gonna need a computer. So I'm gonna be using my laptop, Acer Predator gaming computer. Now, this can be a desktop computer, this can be a Mac, can be a Windows, whatever you want, but we definitely need a computer capable of live streaming. What that really means is we really want something that's just powerful enough, but ideally you want a 16 gig computer that can handle the processing. If you're on the Intel side, you wanna look at an i7. If you're looking at Ryzen computers, a Ryzen 5 would be your minimum basic specs to really make sure that we have enough processing power for your live stream. Now, the camera that I suggest and I really like for small ministries is the PTZ Optics camera. Now, the reason I like this camera is because it's a pan, tilt, and zoom camera. That means you can literally pan it, tilt it, and zoom it in and out on your subject. This camera allows you to zoom in tight, it allows you to zoom out wide, it allows you to get more of a dynamic shot because a still shot is just boring to watch. So this camera will alleviate all of that in one camera. Now, on the back of this camera, this specific model is a USB, which means it's just one cable, USB out into USB in onto our laptop. Or in your case, it may be a computer or a MacBook. It's just one cable out of the camera and into the computer. And then we also have our normal power adapter, power brick that we plug into the wall. So just make sure you're near an outlet, and that way you can have power coming to your camera. Now, if you are on your network, you can plug this in over a PoE switch, which means you can have power over Ethernet, and you actually would alleviate the need for this power brick. So I'm gonna get started and plug this camera in. I have power underneath my desk, so I'm gonna unplug this. So I'm gonna plug the power into the back of the camera here. And I'm also going to mount this camera as well, because it does have the ability to mount it underneath on a typical tripod. And because it's a large base, you can leave it stationary on a flat surface, or you can purchase a base stand that will allow you to attach it to a wall if you wanted to do so as well. So I'm going to attach it to my tripod up here at the top. So I'm going to unscrew this. Screw my tripod into the base and mount it up on the top and tighten. So here's my USB cable that we're going to use to connect it from the camera to the computer directly. So in the back, USB. And then we're going to connect it to our computer via USB as well. And we're going to power on our camera. You'll see that the camera turns on and we're good to go. Now the PTZ Optics camera can be controlled a few different ways. One of them is within your software, but because we're using the Restream software, they don't have the integration with the PTZ camera. So we're actually going to use a controller, and this makes it easier to pan, tilt, and zoom. So I'm going to be using, for this example, the Huddlecam controller. So this is the Huddlecam controller, and I'll link to this in the description as well. And this allows us to connect not only one PTZ camera, but if we wanted to have multiple cameras throughout the sanctuary, we can control all of them through this one controller. So we're going to go ahead and get this all powered up as well. We have our power cable for the controller. So we're gonna plug this in. And we're gonna plug power into the back here. And then we're also gonna plug in our RS-232 cable from our controller directly into our camera. So on the back of our controller, we'll plug in our DB9 cable. Tighten that, and then we'll plug it into our camera, and now we're all set up and ready to go. And now if I move my joystick up, down, left, and right, you can see that the camera is moving and we're controlling it all from the joystick. Now we have all the physical equipment plugged up. We have our laptop, we have our camera, we have our joystick, and we have the cabling in between. So this is our complete one camera ultimate live streaming setup. One person can control everything right now, right? One joystick and one camera, pretty easy. Now we're gonna jump onto the computer, and this is where we're gonna pull up our Restream software. The thing that I really enjoy about using Restream is it allows you to connect to multiple social platforms at the exact same time. So you don't have to set up individual softwares for individual locations that you wanna live stream to. If you wanna go to Facebook and YouTube at the exact same time, it's really simple to do inside of the Restream platform. And the Restream platform is very user-friendly, so you don't have to worry about a whole bunch of different controls and different scenes. You can really just make it simple for that one person or two people that's operating the behind the scenes live stream. So let's jump into Restream and let me walk you through it. So right now I'm logged into the Restream platform, and on the left hand side you'll see the destinations. This is where I can connect all of my social platforms. In this case, I currently already have a platform set up to go to Amazon Live, to Facebook, to YouTube, and a Facebook group. So you can set up different locations here in Restream. And then on the right-hand side, we have the Enter Live Studio mode. This is where we're gonna go to actually operate the live stream. By clicking on the orange Enter Live Studio, we'll be able to select our camera and our microphone. From here, I'm gonna go into the Settings section and select my PTZ camera. And now you can see I am on the screen with my PTZ camera. And now because I have the joystick, I have the ability to move this camera up, move this camera down, zoom in, and zoom out, all with the joystick. So one person can operate the entire live stream. They can manage the Restream software here on the computer, and with the controller, the person behind the scenes can direct the camera up, down, left, right, and capture whatever needs to be seen. Now, while you're live in the Restream platform, you do have some additional functionality as well. The Restream platform will automatically record your videos and store those for 14 days. In order to retrieve your recordings from Restream, you'll just need to navigate to the left-hand side under video storage and select that option, and your videos will be stored here. You can easily download those in an MP4 format. Another feature with the Restream platform is the ability to integrate your chat. So as your viewers are chatting from Facebook and YouTube, you can see all of those in one centralized location on one easy to use dashboard. Now, this was a demonstration setup of what it looks like to do a one-person operation, one PTZ Optics camera, one software called Restream, and the ability to produce a very nice high-quality broadcast. Now, if this video was of value to you, let me know in the comment section or leave me a question. What can I do to help make this easy for your church and your ministry to get set up and have an awesome live stream production? And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video.